Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, previously we discussed the first four main branches of chemistry. But now I have to discuss the next four branches of chemistry. So the fifth one branch is, that is the industrial chemistry. Now what is the definition of industrial chemistry? That it deals with the study of techniques and chemical processes for the preparation of different industrial products. For example, cement, glass, fertilizers, etc. The word industrial is derived from the word industries. It means that the chemistry which is involved in the industries is studied in this branch of chemistry. As we know that in industries, different products are prepared. And that products were passing through different techniques and processes. So, the study of techniques and processes which are used for the production of different industrial products is called industrial chemistry. Now, I can explain it through a very simple example. Like the first one is the fertilizers. Now, what are fertilizers which are used to increase the production of crops? In past, the farmers use animal manure to increase the production of crops. But nowadays, the chemical fertilizer is used, which is called as urea, is used for the production of crops. And that urea is passes through different techniques and processes and then come to us in the form of urea. So that is the industrial product, and that study is called as the industrial chemistry. The same is the second one example, that is the soap. The soap is also comes through different techniques and processes. The medicine also comes to us through different techniques and processes, and the glass or plastics, etc., are also comes to us through different techniques and processes. So that study is called as the industrial chemistry. After the discussion of the industrial chemistry, now we have to discuss the next branch of chemistry, that is the nuclear chemistry. Now, what is nuclear chemistry? It is concerned with the study of nucleus, changes occurring in the nucleus, properties of the particles present in the nucleus, and the emission or absorption of radiation from the nucleus. As the name indicates, that the nuclear word is derived from the word nucleus. It means that in this branch of chemistry, we study about the nucleus. So in this branch, we study the physical properties of particles present in the nucleus, the changes occurring in the nucleus, and the third one is the emission or absorption of radiation from the nucleus. Now, first we discuss the physical properties of particles. As we know that the particles which are present in the nucleus are two. That is protons, and another one is the neutrons. So protons and neutrons both are heavier particles, so they are present in the center of atom, which is called as the nucleus. So simple, we can say that protons have the positive charge while neutrons have no charge. The second one, that is the changes occurring in the nucleus. The changes occurring in the nucleus, we can explain it through a very simple terms, that is fusion and fission. Fusion means combination, while fission means breakdown. So we can explain the fusion with the help of a very simple example, that why the sun gives off heat. It is just because the two nuclei of hydrogen atoms combine together and form the nuclei of helium. So that's the reason that the sun gives off heat. The second one is fission, which means breakdown. So the element whose atomic number is equal or greater than 82 can cause fission, means can break down spontaneously. Like that is the element, and that whose atomic number is greater than 82, it is spontaneously break down into the smaller particles. So that breakdown can also releases energy, or we say that the emission of radiation also occurs. So that one is the fission. We can say that fission can occurs, means the breakdown of different elements can occur. Now the third one is the emission or absorption of radiations. So from the nucleus. So how we can say that the emission of radiation occurs, and why we say that the absorption of radiation occurs? Emission of radiations, we can say that the combination of nuclei with lower mass than 56 means those atoms whose atomic mass is lower than 56, they emit energy. Whenever the nuclei whose atomic number is, whose atomic mass is less than 56, when they combine together, they emit energy. Like hydrogen, whose atomic mass is 1, like oxygen, whose atomic mass is 16. The next one, why the absorption of radiation, or where the absorption of radiation occurs, the combination of nuclei with mass greater than 56, or we say those nuclei whose atomic mass is greater than 56, when combined together, here they need the absorption of radiations. Like for example, uranium. So that whole explanation about the nucleus is studied in this branch of chemistry, which is nuclear chemistry. After the discussion of the nuclear chemistry, we can discuss the seventh one branch of chemistry, that is the biochemistry. And here its definition is that it is concerned with the study of synthesis, composition, decomposition, and chemical reaction of substances which take place in the living organisms. As the word bio means life, means that it is related to the living organisms. So the chemistry which is involved in the living organisms is called as the biochemistry. So synthesis, composition, decomposition, and the chemical reaction of substances which takes place in the living organisms is studied in this branch of chemistry. Now first we have to discuss about the synthesis. What does it mean? Synthesis means formation. And I can explain it through a very simple example, that is in plants. As we know that during the photosynthesis, the glucose is formed. And how the glucose is prepared, when the carbon dioxide and water combines together, then it forms glucose and oxygen gas. So here the synthesis of means the formation of glucose occurs. The second one is composition, which means something which is made up of, like proteins are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So that is its composition. The next one is decomposition. Decomposition means breakdown. When we take food, it is broken down into the smaller pieces and gives off energy, means digestion. In case of digestion, the energy is released and the food is broken down into the smaller pieces. The last one is the chemical reactions of substances, which takes place in the living organisms. So chemical reaction, we can say that the sum of all chemical reactions which are occurring in living organisms is termed as metabolism. Now metabolism is also of two types, anabolism and catabolism. Anabolism means synthesis, while catabolism means breakdown. Synthesis of what? The synthesis of compounds. And breakdown of what? Breakdown of compounds. So the 20 different amino acids, when combined together, then it forms protein. So it means that it is the synthesis or formation of a compound protein. While the catabolism, we say that in case of digestion, the protein is broken down into the amino acids. It means that is the catabolism. So that study is called as the biochemistry. Now we discuss the last branch of chemistry, that is environmental chemistry. Its definition is that it is concerned with the interaction of chemical substances or processes with the environment and their impact on it. As the word environmental shows, environment means atmosphere. So the chemicals which are involved in the atmosphere and the relationship of atmosphere with the living organisms. This is all studied in this branch of chemistry. Now I can simply explain this environmental chemistry with a very simple example or with a very simple definition, like that what is the impact of living organisms on environment, and then in turn what is the impact of environment on living organisms is studied in this branch of chemistry. So I can give a very simple example of that, like carbon dioxide, which is present in the atmosphere, that is taken by the plants, which is the living thing, or we say that the living organism. Then that plant convert the carbon dioxide into the oxygen gas and releases it into the atmosphere. That oxygen is then taken up by the animals and human beings, which are the living organisms. So here we can easily see that how the atmosphere has an impact on the living organisms and how the living organisms has an impact on the atmosphere. An example shows that the vehicles which are used for the transportation purposes can give off harmful gases like nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitric oxide, etc. Means that simple we say that it causes the air pollution. So that is the impact of human beings or living organisms on the atmosphere. The vehicles are used by the living organisms, which gives off harmful gases to the environment, to the atmosphere. So that is the impact of living organism on environment. Then that air pollution can cause different diseases in living organism, and that is the impact of environment on living organisms. So that all are studied, studied it in the environmental chemistry. At the last, I'll give you the brief summary of today's lecture. So the first one we discussed, that is the industrial chemistry, which is the fifth branch of chemistry, which where we can use it in industries. I can tell you that the different techniques and processes which are used for the production of different products, that is the, we can study it in the industrial chemistry. Where we can give the examples for the fertilizers, soap, medicine and glass, etc. The next branch we discuss is the nuclear chemistry. As I previously said, that it is the chemistry involved in the nucleus, means it is the total study of the nucleus, where we can discuss the physical properties of the particles present in the nucleus, the changes occurring in the nucleus, where we can explain the fission and fusion. And the third one is the emission or absorption of radiation from the nucleus, where we can discuss that the nuclei, when combined together, whose atomic mass is lower than 56, they can always emit energy, while the combination of nuclei whose atomic mass is greater than 56 always absorbs energy. The next one, the seventh one branch, that is the biochemistry. So in biochemistry, we say that it is the study of living organisms, in which we can discuss the synthesis, composition, decomposition, and the chemical reactions which take place in the living organisms are studied in this branch of chemistry. In the synthesis, we can give the example simple of photosynthesis, where the glucose is formed. In composition, we say that how the protein is made up of, from which elements protein is made up of, that is from carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. In decomposition, we can say that the food is broken down into the smaller pieces and it gives off energy. The next one is the chemical reactions. We can say that all the chemical reactions which are occurring in the nuclear and the living organisms is called as the metabolism. Then we can also explain the metabolism into two types, that is anabolism and catabolism. In anabolism, the synthesis of compounds takes place, while in catabolism, the breakdown of compounds takes place. Now the last branch, that is the environmental chemistry, in which we study that the impact of the living organisms on environment and the impact of environment on the living organisms, where we discuss the very simple example, that is of carbon dioxide, which is present in the atmosphere, is taken by the plants, and then plants can change the carbon dioxide into the oxygen, and that oxygen is then taken by the animals and human beings. So that is the simple example of the impact of atmosphere on the living organisms, and then the impact of living organisms on the environment.